Hello friends, in this video we are going to solve a numerical problem based on one-way ANOVA. But before watching this video, I will strongly recommend you to watch my previous video on one-way ANOVA. Link of that video is given here. So let's take the question. So question is, to assess the significance of possible variation in performance in a certain test between the convent schools of a city. A common test was given to a number of students taken at a random from the fifth class of the three schools concerned. The results given below. For school A, marks are 9, 11, 13, 9 and 8. For school B, it is 13, 12, 10, 15 and 5. And for school C, it is 14, 13, 17, 7 and 9. Now make an analysis of variance for the given data. Now coming to the solution of this problem. So first we will take the given data of these three schools. This video is sponsored by Pharma Tutor. They provide job alerts, Pharma newsletters, admission alerts, articles and many more. You can also join online test series for GPAT preparation. Download dedicated Pharma Tutor app for regular notifications. Visit www.pharmatutor.org for more details. Link is given in the description. So these are the marks for school A, B and C. Now for solving this question through one-way ANOVA, table will be like this. So by using this table, we can find the analysis of variance for this data. Now let's coming to this data. So 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 9 plus 8 is equal to 50. 13 plus 12 plus 10 plus 15 plus 5 is equal to 55. And 14 plus 13 plus 17 plus 7 plus 9 is equal to 60. Now let's take the x a bar. So x a bar is equal to 50 divided by total number of observations are 5, so it will be 10. Now coming to the second one, that is x b bar. So x b bar is equal to 55 divided by total number of observations are again 5, so it will be 11. Now coming to the third one, which is x c bar. So x c bar is equal to 60 divided by total number of observations, which are 5. So 60 by 5 is equal to 12. Now coming to the grand mean, that is x double bar. So x double bar is equal to x a bar plus x b bar plus x c bar divided by number of observations, which is 1, 2 and 3, so it will be divided by 3. So it will be equal to x a bar is equal to 10, x b bar is equal to 11 and x c bar is equal to 12 divided by 3. So ultimately it will be 33 divided by 3. And the x double bar will be equal to 11. Now coming to the next step. In next step, we will calculate the SSC, means variance between the samples. So for calculation of SSC, first we have to make a table, and the table will be like this. So first column is for x a bar minus x double bar. Second column is for x a bar minus x double bar square. Third column is for x b bar minus x double bar. Fourth column is for x b bar minus x double bar square. Fifth column is for x c bar minus x double bar, and the last column is for x c bar minus x double bar square. Now coming to the first column where x a bar minus x double bar is taken. Here readings are different, but for all these readings we will take x a bar because it is calculation of SSC, means between the samples. So here x a bar is equal to 10 minus x double bar is equal to 11. So ultimately it will be equal to minus 1. And we will write this calculation 5 times because here we are having 5 observations. So it will be again 10 minus 11 is equal to minus 1. 10 minus 11 is equal to minus 1. 10 minus 11 is equal to minus 1. And last one is again 10 minus 11 is equal to minus 1. Now coming to the square of minus 1, because it is x a bar minus x double bar square, it means square of this one. So it will be 1, it will be 1, it will be 1, it will be 1, and it will be 1. Now coming to the next one, which is summation x bar minus x double bar. So here for this column it is x a, so it will be x a bar minus x double bar, and the value is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 5. Now coming to the next column where we are taking x b bar. So value of x b bar is equal to 11 minus x double bar is equal to 11. So it will be 0. In next also 11 minus 11 is equal to 0. 11 minus 11 is equal to 0. 11 minus 11 is equal to 0. 11 minus 11 is equal to again 0. So ultimately we will square these all zeros. So it will be again 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0. And the sum of all these 0 will be 0. Now coming to the next column where we have to take x c bar minus x double bar. So x c bar is equal to 12 minus x double bar is equal to 11. So it will be 1. Again it will be 12 minus 11 is equal to 1. 12 minus 11 is equal to 1. 12 minus 11 is equal to 1. And 12 minus 11 is equal to 1. So we will square all this one. So it will be again 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1. And the sum of all this 1 will be 5. Now coming to the calculation of SSC. So SSC is equal to summation x a bar minus x double bar plus summation x b bar minus x double bar square. It will be square plus summation x c bar minus x double bar square. So it will be equal to x a bar minus x double bar square is equal to 5 plus summation x b bar minus x double bar square is equal to 0 plus summation x c bar minus x double bar square is equal to again 5. So it will be ultimately 5 plus 0 plus 5 is equal to 10. So value of SSC is equal to 10. And here we have to calculate the value of degree of freedom, which is nu is equal to C minus 1. So here C is the number of columns. So here 1, 2 and 3 column is present. So 3 minus 1. So degree of freedom or nu 1 is equal to 2. Now coming to the calculation of MSC. So MSC is equal to SSC divided by nu 1. So SSC is equal to 10 divided by nu 1 is equal to 2. So ultimately it will be 5. So here we have already calculated the data for SSC or between the samples. Now we have to calculate the data for within the sample, that is calculation of SSE. So here column A is for A minus X A bar. Column B is for A minus X A bar square. Column C is for B minus X B bar. Column D is for B minus X B bar square. And the next column is for C minus X C bar. And the last column is for c minus x c bar square. Now coming to the first data column A, that is 9. So 9 minus x a bar is equal to 10. So 9 minus 10 is equal to minus 1. Second one is 11. So 11 minus 10 is equal to plus 1. Third one is 13. So 13 minus 10 is equal to 3. Next one is 9. So 9 minus 10 is equal to minus 1. And the last one is 8. So 8 minus 10 is equal to minus 2. Now we have to square all these values. So minus 1 square is equal to 1, 1 square is equal to 1, 9 is 3 square is equal to 9, minus 1 is equal to 1, minus 2 square is equal to 4. So summation value, which can also be written as summation x, x means a, b or c, minus x bar square. So it will be equal to 1 plus 1, 2 plus 9, 11, 11 plus 1, 12, 12 plus 4, 16. Now coming to the second column, which is column B. So here it is, B is equal to 13, 13 minus XB bar, which is 11. So 13 minus 11 is equal to 2. Next one is 12. So 12 minus 11 is equal to 1. Next one is 10. So 10 minus 11 is equal to minus 1. Next one is 15. So 15 minus 11 is equal to 4. Next one is 5. So 5 minus 11 is equal to 6. Now we have to square all these values. So 2 square is equal to 4. 1 square is equal to 1. Minus 1 square is equal to 1. 4 square is equal to 16. 6 square is equal to 36. So total will be 4 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 6. 6 plus 16 is equal to 22. 22 plus 36 is equal to 58. Now coming to the column C. So in column C, it is 14. So 14 minus XC bar, which is 12. So 14 minus 12 is equal to plus 2. Next one is 13. 13 minus 12 is equal to plus 1. Next one is 17. So 17 minus 12 is equal to 5. Next one is 7. So 7 minus 12 is equal to minus 5. And the last one is 9. So 9 minus 12 is equal to minus 3. Now 2 square is equal to 4. 1 square is equal to 1. 5 square is equal to 25. Minus 5 square is equal to again 25. Minus 3 square is equal to 9. Now we have to add all these values. So 25 plus 25 is equal to 50. 50 plus 9 is equal to 59. 59 plus 1 is equal to 60. 60 plus 4 is equal to 64. Now we have to calculate the value of SSE. SSE is equal to summation A minus X A bar square plus summation B minus X B bar square plus summation C minus X C bar square. So value of X minus X A bar square is equal to 16 plus value of B minus X B bar square is equal to 58 plus value of summation C minus X C bar square is equal to 64. So 16 plus 58 plus 64 is equal to 138. Now we will put this 138 in this table. So SSE is equal to 138. Degree of freedom nu is equal to n. So n is equal to, here 3 columns are there and 5 rows are there. So 5 into 3 is equal to 15 minus number of columns. So it is 1, 2 and 3. So it will be 15 minus 3, and 15 minus 3 is equal to 12. Now coming to the value of MSE. So MSE is equal to SSE, which is 138 divided by nu 2, that is degree of freedom. So it is 12. So 138 divided by 12 is equal to 11.5. Now we will calculate the value of F. So value of F is equal to value of MSE, that is 5, divided by value of MSE, that is 11.5. So it will be approximately equal to 0.435. So calculated F value is 0.435. Now we have to find out the tabulated F value for degree of freedom. Nu 1 is equal to 2 and nu 2 is equal to 12. And it is 3.89, as F table is given in your screen. So here our tabulated value is greater than the calculated value. It means our null hypothesis is passed, which means there is no variation between all these three schools, which are A, B and C. So this is the complete solution about this question. Now in my next video, I will take another question and we will solve that question. Thank you.